Yes, indeed. It is minus 13 right now. Got down to minus 14 last night. Here in the wilds of my backyard. It's Shug. I've just woken up from a warm slumber. But really, I just wanted to get out here and be in my winter tarp. And we're going to come out here and take a little in-depth look at that today, because I keep getting asked about it, and it's in various videos, but I don't think I've ever done a video just on this tarp. And I'm going to talk a little bit about my breath catcher here, my frost bib, which is just a fleece, part of a fleece shirt I just cut up one time. And when I sleep, I just take this hole, lay it around my head, hooks up on my ridge line with a prussic knot, and just a little S-beaner that goes to a little small hole I cut right there. And as I lay here in the night breathing, you can see that it catches a lot of the condensation and frost and keeps it off my top quilt. That's all I got to say about that. Slept out here last night. I have my hammock gear. I call it a top quilt insert, about a 30 degree. Got my war bonnet, 0 degree Black Mamba. Underneath me, I got the Greylock 4 underquilt. It's a partial underquilt from Jax or Better. And I have my 2QZQ underquilt protector around that. Because the Greylock is about a, they say it's a 0 degree to minus 5 under quilt. And since it got to minus 14, I thought I would just boost it up. I got my down parka that I zip around my foot box of my hammock. Normally in camp, I'd have that for wearing around in the day, but wouldn't be sleeping in it at night. So my feet were toasty warm. I'm only wearing one pair of socks, and that would be Expedition smart wool socks, those right there, just one pair. Feet great all night, slept very warm. Got on my hood, my face mask, my balaclava. I got a Black Rock gear hat and my little blue beanie I always wear. All right, that was a lot of info coming at you here in one big soliloquy. I'm going in to have some coffee now, because I just exhausted myself doing all that talking. Woo, buddy. There you go, minus 13 degrees right now. And it got down to let me hit the low on here. Got down to minus 14. And I guess it was 52 degrees in my pocket. This is a little Springfield thermometer I got years ago from a hardware store. You can get stuff like this on Amazon. It's got a little transmitter right there. This part I keep in my pocket, and it records the high and low temperature inside and outside. So inside would be inside my pocket right there, which was 70 degrees. Right now it just went to minus 12 is what it is out here in this very second. Hey everybody, Shug here. Today we're going to take an in-depth look at my winter tarp. This tarp has become my winter tarp. It weighs about 2 pounds after all the add-ons. The reason I don't mind carrying that is because I usually pull a pulk these days when I winter camp. It's a sled I drag behind me. Living here in Minnesota, I find if I've got a big, heavier pack on my back with the snowshoes, I'm sinking down in the snow. So I prefer to just pull the pulk. I can have the benefit of adding just a little bit more stuff and not fret about if my tarp is a pound and a half or 2 pounds. Actually, it's minus 2 as we speak. That is the outside temperature right now. I just had this in my pocket, so the top temperature would be the inside. As you can see, it says in right there. And bottom, outside. Now, this tarp just started out as one of my first tarps. First tarp I ever made, I made it out of the wrong kind of material, just ripstop, and it leaked like crazy. But it was good practice. Then I made 3 more tarps. One I gave to Hicks, one I gave to Turk. This is my original. It did not have doors. Check out the picture right here. Okay, you've checked that out. Then what I did is I decided I wanted doors, and I wanted them to close completely. So this is what they look like. Pretty much closed up. I used Velcro so that they would stay. And I'll cover this little detail up here in a second that will shut all the way up, or I can open it up to let my suspension out, or just to let a little air flow through to reduce any condensation in there. And I very rarely get condensation inside this tarp. Here in the front, I normally set my doors this way. One just blocking the wind, one just open, so that I can just zip in and out of the tarp as I please. Well, my camera battery is going dead because of the cold. I went in to grab another one, and my wife said, "A box came from you. What did you order now?" Couldn't remember ordering anything, but a box came from a Hammock Forum member who had asked me a while back, going, "Sugar, I noticed you like that Justin's peanut butter and always eat it. Well, my daughter works for the factory. Would you like some?" Well, looky here. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my favorite, the little packs. Woo, buddy! What is this? Justin's peanut butter cups. Mmm. Crunchy on the outside. Mmm. Peanut butter soft in the middle. Justin's organic peanut butter cups, or as I like to call them, orgasmic. But let's take a look at these doors, why I added Velcro. And keep in mind, I did this like 7 years ago, and I'm actually glad I did the Velcro. It comes in handy. I'm gonna show you why. Now, number one, this tarp is made out of Sil nylon. If you've never sewn Sil nylon, well, just sew some and see. It's slippery, so you'll fight with your machine a little bit. And if you're gonna sew a tarp, learn to use your sewing machine first. I'm not gonna show you how to sew one. I will probably never sew another one. There's so many good ones available. And I have this. Unless I destroy this, maybe I'd make another one. But this is not a sewing tutorial, just a looky-see. And what I like about this is I have sewn these little tabs on here. It'll give me an idea of where I can place the Velcro. And it's not as hard to do as it may seem. It's a little tighter in the back, but I just kind of pull it like this, because this is my door that's going to remain shut. And I just pull it down, rub it with my fingers. Down at the bottom here, I have a little hook and two tabs, where if it was really windy, and I've never had to use this, I can hook these two tabs together and my tarp doors don't blow open. But I actually never had them blow open with the Velcro. Yeah, I did sew the Velcro on. It's a little frustrating to do, but you know, I knew the sticky back stuff just wouldn't work. So this is the Velcro without the sticky back. And I just stitched it on and cursed a lot and slung things across the room. Now, I'm gonna explain this little part at the top here, where I can pull these down, kind of what my ideas were at the time. Keep in mind, I was really new to sewing, but in the end, I'm kind of glad I did this, even though it added a little bit more weight. Okay, here's what we're looking at right here. Here's my tarp line coming out. This is my strap hammock suspension going right there to my fence. Now, my idea here was to have this Velcro, which I sewed on the side of my tarp, just down about here. I'd say about 11, 12 inches. I can adjust these to sort of where I want. I can put them all the way up if I like, and just have that open as my tarp coming through. I'm not really sure what I was thinking at the time, but I actually sort of like the way it worked, because it gives me the ability to switch my venting as much as I'd like. Nice to get a little cross breeze coming through once in a while, just to keep the condensation out. Okay, now again, we're gonna look at these little lines I sewed in there. That's on the inside of the tarp right there. And this is the outside. If I did it again, I would have this a little longer. But when I want to tie the tarp back, just tie a simple knot, and I have that long part so that I can do this slippery half hitch like that. And then that's easy to pull out when I want it done. There's a little view of them right there on the inside of the tarp. Velcro inside the flap, a little tab I sewn. Used a little Grogain right here just to make these. Got an S-beaner here to some shock cord so that I can pitch that door off. Just to create a little wind block if I need to. And I often need to. Really, for the most part though, unless it's super windy, I always just leave one door open. So I hope that explains that a little bit. Now let's go inside and look at the pole mod. The pole mod is this right here. I have a pole curving around inside the tarp. It slides into that little pocket right there. One thing is I learned I liked using a stake, and we're gonna go over this this method right here with the line locks. It's called the Shane method, and I find it really easy. Sort of pulls my tarp down on the sides. So the pole mod goes over the top. And what I like really is rather than using my pullouts like I used to use way back when I was doing my tarp series, my snow would pile up on top. With the pole mod there in the middle, the snow tends to slide off a little bit more. But one thing, snow has its own personality, and snow will kind of cling on sill nylon. What I find the best thing to do is if you're in your tarp and snow's piling up, just take your hand to bang your tarp and the snow will slide off. I invented that. I did. All right, so here I am laying in the hammock. And you can see my pole mod goes down to a little pocket there. It goes around the inside to a little pocket there. I got this pole at Fiberplex. I think it's carbon fiber. It's in sections. I took an old tent pole and just kind of taped off my tarp. And I had ordered these pockets here. That little pocket was an add-on. You can get that from 2QZQ. And they're the same people that make the underquilt protector. 2QZQ! Hammock Specialties. And the pole slips right down into a little notch. And then you just kind of estimate your length and hope that you get it right. Mine was probably about a quarter of an inch too long, but I don't care. And then what you got to do is you have a piece of line right there, and I had to sew that into the ridge line. I reinforced it and seam sealed it. And you've got to be able to tie your pole off, otherwise your pole will slide back and forth on the tarp. I'll show you that. So if it's not tied off, you can see it wants to slide around. And that's what holds your pole. And you order this from 2QZQ, add it on to the hem of your tarp, and that is your pole mod pocket. Easy to make your own, but it's kind of one of those little fiddly deals. I just ordered them because, once again, like I always say, I'm a lazy man and I'm tired of sewing. So glad I did it, and I just sewed it on, and now I got a pole mod. Some people like a pole mod on the outside of their tarp. Some people use the pole mod where it's two pieces that go over the top and hook to your pullouts. But in snow, and we're talking snow and winter camping here, I find this sheds the snow really well for me. So I've not had to ever do it yet, but I often think like, man, if I'm out there in a really heavy snow, what would I do? Because I pretty much just run my rigging. I go right off my D-rings. These are my snake skins here for the tarp. Go out to a Dutch wasp and hook it to the tree. Now, if I were out in the woods and we were getting some serious snow, I carry a piece of line, I would tie it to the tree and run it underneath the tarp to support it. And if it was really serious, I would cut me a limb and put my tarp over that. But so far, I've not really run into those kind of conditions. You always kind of hope for them, but I check the weather before I go and just get what I get. And one thing about if you're going to use a tarp in the winter, just realize that you're using a tarp in the winter. If you don't want any wind coming in, stick with a tent. This is the tarp life. You're going to get a breeze or some spin drift once in a while. I just love it because I want to be in my hammock. And I'm willing to fool with it and mess with it. And it's part of really what I enjoy about the camping is even in winter, if I want, I can pitch this up into porch mode. Wanted to take a second here and show you this Greylock 4 from Jack's or Better partial underquilt that I slept in last night. Now by partial, What I mean is it only comes down to, oh, just around behind my knees, but you can see how fluffy that is. Now there's a little gap right there, but the minute I'm in the hammock, that goes away. And then I always take my, because it's just a fail safe. You know, if you're winter camping, you've always got a parka or a big vest on top of everything else. Well, I just take it and zip it over the end of my hammock like that. I tuck my sleeves on the inside so there's a little bit more down on my feet. And my feet are down in that. That's why I just have one pair of wool socks. Guaranteed warm feet. Because otherwise, this is just laying in your pack or somewhere else. I sleep in a little, like last night, I had on an insulated shirt, then a really thin 100 layer fleece shirt, and then just because I was sort of lazy last night, I was wearing my down sweater from Outdoor Research, that orange one. I just slept in that. I had on one pair of thin merino wool long johns, and then I had my 100 weight fleece tights that, if you look at my cracking cold clothes system, you can see most of this stuff. So just two layers on my legs, and that way when I get up in the morning, I got some clothes on, and then I can just jump up and slip on whatever else I need to. Now, as far as staking my tarp out in the snow, I'm using what is called Shane's method. He's a guy on hammock forums, and this just is smart, at least for me in the winter. So I have a piece of shock cord that goes down to a line lock here that I can release and tighten, release and tighten, lock it off like that, because you're constantly doing that with your tarp in winter. You see, like, you'll walk away from camp, come back, and your tarp will be saggy. You just easily come over, grab that line lock, pull it tight. Now you got a tight tarp. Then what I use, I always use the Spear No Tangle line that you can get at TTT Trail Gear. It's just a Spectra line. I go to an S-beaner right there, and under that S-beaner is my snow stake. Snow stake is pretty set in the snow right there right now. So that's hooked in, but if I want to unhook, I just do that. Then my tarp is free, and that's how I let my tarp down. Now I have these logs on here, because what happens when you set up winter camp, and a lot of times you get these stakes down in the snow and it's not set yet, and you kind of put your tarp up just really loosely, like that, so it's hardly pulling on it, and I wait for that to set, and then a little later, half hour or so, whatever the snow, I can come in and totally tighten that up. Now I like snow stakes. I carry them. I know a lot of people say you can go cut a stick or a log, and I could certainly have that loop and just go cut me a thick stick and bury that in the snow. But I have these with me, and the reason I use them, I'll put these, is again why I like the snow stakes is because when I'm setting up in the winter and I've packed out, gotten to my site, you got a lot of chores to do, and I just don't always want to go look for those sticks to use as snow stakes. Sometimes if it's snowing, you just want to get set up. Again, this is just me because I'm lazy and I'm pulling a pulk. I find carrying six of those stakes saves me a lot of work of trying to find those sticks or cutting those sticks or looking in the snow or having to walk out and cut them off, because you do need a decent sized stick to get in there. But that's just me, and if I forgot them, I know that I could use a stick. So etsy ketsy, yaku taco, kum si kum sa, bahala na, one way or the other, up or down, black or white, yin or yang. So yeah, if your stake has been down in the snow for a little while, you're probably going to have to dig it out. But again, that just kind of depends on the snow conditions, the snowpack, the wind, just a lot of things. So carrying a little something like a Black Diamond snow shovel with you is really handy for piling up snow around your tarp. You'll see it in other videos of mine. I'm not going to really feature that now, but you need something to move snow with in snow camping. So anyway, that's my winter tarp.
I gotta wrap this up because it's starting to get downright cold out here.